Now the question is 5/10 and 9/10. This question is given to you, and here you have to compare the fraction on the number line. So then how do you compare? So first you draw a number line. See this one? The denominator is equivalent to 10. So it means we write down 0 here, and here I am writing 1. So it means we have to divide a line into 10 equal parts. 10 equal parts means 10 equal parts means 9 lines between these two lines. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. So these are the 9 lines, or you can say parts. How many parts? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and these are the 10 parts. Okay, now the first number is 5. In the first number, the numerator is equivalent to 5. So, fifth line after 0. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So, this one is called 5/10. The next is 9/10. It means ninth line. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. This one is the ninth line. So we can say it is 9/10. Okay. So it means 9/10 is farther than the 5/10 from 0. So we can say 5/10 is smaller than the 9/10. So in this way you can calculate, you can compare numbers on the number line. Okay. I explain you one question from module number 2. Here the question is 7/10 and this one is 9/10. Here you have to compare the numbers. Because just see here, denominators are equivalent to each other. It means if the denominators are equal, it means the smaller, we check only the numerator. It means 7 is smaller than 9. So we can say 7/10 is smaller than 9/10. But when the denominators are equal, then we check only like this. Okay. In our first A part. In the second part, if I am taking one more example, that is 3/5 and 3/6. Here numerator is equivalent. Here the numerators are equal. So what we do here, numerators are equal. It means we can say 5, and 5 is smaller than 6. So we can say 3/5 is greater than 3/6. But when the numerators are equal, these are equal. So we can say it is opposite of this one. 5 is smaller than 6. So we can say 3/5 is greater than the 3/6. So here you put the symbol of greater. Okay. Or the another method is that, as I explained you, by the method of cross multiplication. You can use the cross multiplication method. Suppose I am taking this example. 1/4 and 1/5, you have to compare 1/4 and 1/5. If sometime you forgot this one, then what you do here, you do the cross multiplication. 5 goes here, so 1 into 5, and this one is 1 into 4. So it is 5 and 4. Which one is greater? 5 is greater, so we can put symbol here, greater. So 1/4 is greater than the 1/5. Okay everyone. Now come to the module number 3. In this module, you have to change the unlike fraction into a like fraction. Unlike fraction into a like fraction. So what is the meaning of like fraction and unlike fraction, and what is the difference between them? Suppose you have a number that is 3/2, 4/5, 6/3. These all are called unlike fraction because they have different denominators. If they have different denominators, then we can say these all are the unlike fraction. But for the like fraction, you have a number 3/2, 6 upon 2, 1 upon 2, 5 upon 2. These all have same denominator. So we can say these all are the like fraction. For the like fraction, we can do addition and subtraction just like normal numbers. Okay, understand this one? So now in this module, we convert unlike fraction into a like fraction. Now here we have a question, 3 upon 25, 4 upon 5, 7 upon 15. Here we have to convert these number into a like fraction because they have different denominators. So these are unlike fraction. Now we convert it into like fraction. So what we do here, first we take the LCM of these numbers. First we find the LCM of these numbers. So how do we find? We use the division method to find the LCM. We can use 5 or we can use 3 also we can use. But actually, okay, I am using 3. 3 5s are 15. Now 5 5s are 5 1s are 5 here and 5 1 1 and 1 1. So LCM is 3 multiply 5 multiply 5. That is 3 5s are 15, 15 5s are 75. So this is the LCM which we find out. Okay. Now I'm erasing this one. So LCM is 75. Now we convert these all denominator into 75. Okay. LCM is equal to 75. Then how do we compare? Now I'm taking first numbers 3 upon 25. So by which number I multiply this number so that the denominator becomes 75? If I am multiplying 75 into 3. If I am multiplying this one to 3. So 3 3's are 9 and 25 into 3, 75. If you are not able to find out and how do we find, then what you do here, you make a rough column and divide 75 by 25 and cut them and you will get 3. So the required number is 3. So you multiply all the numerator and denominator by 3 upon 3. Okay. So in this way you will get 3 into 3, 9 and 25 into 3, 75. Same way 4 upon 5. Now this number is 4 upon 5. So by which number we multiply 5 so that this number becomes 75. Then how do we calculate? 75 upon 5. Or you do one thing, 5 divided. 5 into 1, 5, 2 and 5, 5 5s are. It means you multiply this number by 15. So you multiply 4 upon 5 by 15 upon 15. 15 4s are 60 and 75 and this one is 75. Next is 7 upon 15. Now same thing you apply again. You divide 25 by We divide 75 by 15 and 15 5s are 75. So you multiply the number by 5 upon 5. 7 upon 15 multiply 5 upon 5. 7 5s are 35 and this one is 15 5s are 75. So in this way you can convert all the number into like fraction and write down the first number 9 upon 25 comma 60 upon 75, 35 upon 75. So these all are the like fraction. Okay. Now let's take one more example, that is B part, 4 upon 7 now let's take one more example that is 4 upon 7 comma 9 upon 14 and 11 upon 28. Here you have to convert again into a like fractions. So first thing is that first you find the LCM. LCM is 7, 14 and 28. So you divide it by 2 because 2 is the smallest number. So 2 7s are and 2 14s are. Then again you can divide it by 2. And this one is by 7. 2 2s are 4. 4 7s are 28. So LCM is 28. It means we convert the denominator into 28. LCM is 28. Now first number is 4 upon 7. So by which number you multiply this one? So one thing is that you divide 28 divided by 7 is equal to 4. It means you divide, you multiply the number by 4 by 4. 4 4s are 16 upon 7 4s are 28. Next again 9 upon 14. Same thing you do here. 28 divided by 14. This is equivalent to 2. So you multiply the whole number by 2 upon 2. So 9 2s are 18 and this is 28. And this is the same number. There is no need to change. So the numbers are equivalent. Numbers are 16 upon 28. 18 upon 28 and 11 upon 28 are like fractions. Okay everyone, now come to the module number 4. Here you have to compare the fraction by changing into like fraction. The question is 8 upon 11 and here you have to compare by 4 upon 7. Here you have to convert them into a like fraction. The same way you apply the same method, that is 11 and 7. So find the LCM of 11 and 7, that is these two are the prime numbers, so divided by the same 11, 1 and 1. So it is 7 into 11, that is 77. So you convert all the denominator into 77. So what we do here, first I am writing 11 here. So by which number I multiply so that this denominator becomes 77. Do one thing, 77 divided by 11, that is equal to 7. So multiply this by 7 upon 7. 8 7s are 56 and 11 7s are 77. Next is 4 upon 7, then 4 upon 7. By which number we multiply so that number become 77. So what we do here, 77 divided by 7, it is equivalent to 11. So multiply this by 11 upon 11. So 4 into 11 is equal to 44 and 7 into 11, 77. Now the numbers are, write down accordingly, and 44 and 77. So which one is greater? This one is greater. So accordingly, this one is 8 upon 11 is greater than the 8 upon 11 is greater than the 4 upon 7. So in this way you can compare. Okay. Let's take one more example. Now same thing we apply here. We take the LCM of 24 and 28. So by which number we can divide? We can divide it by 2. 2 12s are and 2 14s are. Then again we can divide it by 2. 2 6s are and 2 7s are. Then again 2. 2 3s are and 7. Write down as it is because 7 is not divisible by 2. Then next number is 3. 3 1s are and 7 is not divisible. 7 1 1. So what is the answer? 2 multiply 2 multiply 2 multiply 3 multiply 7. So 2 2s are 4. 4 2s are 8. 8 3s are 24. 24 7s are 168. So LCM is 168. LCM is 168. Now convert these denominator into 168. Then how do we convert 9 upon 24? Now the same thing we apply here. 168 divided by 24. If we divide them, so what will we get? So we multiply 9 upon 24 by 7 upon 7. This is 63 and 24 7s are 168. Next number is 7 upon 28. So again you do same thing, 6 divided by 28. So divide it, this one 6. So multiply 7 upon 28 to 6 upon 6. So that is सेवन एट जा 42 अपॉन 160. सो दिस इज दीज आर. सो हाउ डू वी राइट नाउ? राइट डाउन द नंबर 63 अपॉन 168 एंड दिस वन इज 48 अपॉन 168. सो विच वन इज ग्रेटर? 63 इज ग्रेटर मीन्स 9 अपॉन 24 इज ग्रेटर. 9 अपॉन 24 इज ग्रेटर देन द 7 अपॉन 28. ओके एवरीवन, सो इन दिस वे यू कैन कंपेयर. So come to the next. Now come to the next module, number 5. In this module, you have to arrange these number in ascending order by putting the appropriate sign. So what we do here, we do same thing. We convert these unlike fraction into a like fraction by the same method. First we find the LCM of these numbers. So we can divide it by 2, 2 into 1. The same thing, 3. 1, 1 and 5 and then again 5, 1, 1. So LCM is 2 into 3 into 5. 2, 3 is 6, 6, 5 is 30. So the LCM is 30. It means we convert 1 upon 2 into the denominator, we convert into 30. So by which number we multiply, so the LCM, so the 2 becomes 30. So we do one same thing, 30 divided by 2, it is equivalent to 15. So multiply it by 15 upon 15. 15 into 1, 15. 15 2s are 30. Next thing, 2 upon 3. 2 upon 3. So by which number we multiply? Same thing, 30 divided by 3. So it is equivalent to 10. So multiply it by 10 upon 10. 2 tens are 20 and it is 30. 3 upon 5, so same thing, 30 divided by 5, we get 6, so multiply by 6 upon 6, 6 3s are 18 and 5 6 are 30. So now you write down these numbers, 15 upon 30 and 20 upon 30 and 18 upon 30. So what are these numbers? It means 18 upon 30 is, so in that way you write down ascending order. Here you have to write, so write down like this. These are in ascending order. And 15 upon 30, 15 upon 30 is equivalent to 1 upon 2. 18 upon 30, 18 upon 30 is equivalent to 3 upon 5. 20 upon 30 is equivalent to 2 upon 3. So in this way you write, you arrange them in ascending order.